This video is about simplifying rational expressions. We're going to take these rational expressions and write them in simplest form. Just like fractions with plain old numbers, we want to have the common factors canceled out. So we're going to factor everything and see if we can cancel anything. So our first example here is 2x squared minus 6x over 2x. So before we can do any canceling, we need to make sure that this numerator and the denominator actually are both written so that we have things being multiplied together. In the numerator here, we have two terms, but it's subtraction there, so we need to see if we can factor that numerator so that we can cancel something. And both 2x squared and negative 6x have 2x in common, so we can factor a 2x out of the numerator, and we would be left with x minus 3. And then this is divided by 2x. Now we have the 2x times this x minus 3, and so now we can cancel these 2x. And so we'll just be left with x minus 3. In our next example here, x squared minus 81 over 9 plus x. So x squared minus 81 can factor, remember this is the difference of two perfect squares, and so it factors as x plus 9 times x minus 9. And then the denominator, 9 plus x, this can be rewritten. You can write the x term first. It's a positive x, so that's x, and then it's a positive 9, so that would be plus 9. And so we can cancel the x plus 9s, and we would be left with x minus 9. In our next example here, x squared minus 10x plus 25 over x minus 5. So I want to factor the x squared minus 10x plus 25. So I need to figure out how I can factor 25 so that the sum of those two factors will give me negative 10. And so negative 5 and negative 5 both multiply to give you positive 25, and they add together to give you the negative 10 in the middle. So this will factor as x minus 5 times x minus 5, and it's being divided by x minus 5. So the x minus 5's cancel, and we're just left with one of the x minus 5's. In example D here, we have x minus 8 over 8 minus x, and so these two, the numerator and the denominator, look very similar, but they are different because remember, subtraction does not commute, and so x minus 8 and 8 minus x are not the same thing. So what I want to do is I want to factor a negative 1 out of the denominator, and let's see what happens when we do that. So if I factor a negative 1 out, then this positive 8 becomes negative 8, and negative x becomes positive x. So in my parentheses, I'll have negative 8 plus x, and if I rewrite that, then we would write the x first, and we have positive x, so that's x, and then we have negative 8, so that's the same as minus 8. And so now we have an x minus 8 on the top and an x minus 8 on the bottom, and so we can cancel them. When we're canceling, we're really dividing these two things, and so there's really a 1 left up on top. And so you can write that 1 in there so that you don't forget. And so we really have 1 divided by negative 1, which is negative 1. In this next example, y squared plus 5y plus 6 over y squared plus 10y plus 21. So we want to factor both the numerator and the denominator. For the numerator fraction, we want to factor 6 so that the sum of the two factors gives us 5. And so the way that we can factor 6 so the sum will give us 5 is 2 and 3. And so the numerator is going to factor as y plus 2 times y plus 3. And for the denominator, we want to factor the 21, the plain old number, so that the sum will give us the number in front of our x term, which is 10. And the two numbers that will multiply to give you 21 and add to give you 10 are 3 and 7. So this will factor as y plus 3 times y plus 7. And this time the y plus 3's are the same on top and bottom, so we can cancel those, and we'll be left with y plus 2 over y plus 7. And in our last example here, we We have y cubed minus 64 over 4y minus 16. And so y cubed minus 64 is the difference of two perfect cubes. So we can factor that. Remember, we had the formula a cubed minus b cubed equals a minus b times the quantity a squared plus ab plus b squared. So we're going to follow this formula for our factoring. And the thing that we would cube to get this 64 is 4. So it's going to be y minus 4. And then it's y squared. And then we change our sign to addition and multiply y and 4 together. So we get 4y in the middle. And then we square the 4. So that's plus 16. And this last term, remember, is always positive. And in the denominator, 4y minus 16, there's a 4 as a common factor. So we're going to factor out a 4. And in the parentheses, then we would be left with y minus 4. And so the y minus 4s can cancel, and we're left with y squared plus 4y plus 16 over 4. And we can't cancel anything else here because this is addition. And it has to be multiplication, so we can't cancel anything else at this point. That ends our lecture on simplifying rational expressions. Let me know if you have any questions. Thank you.